Did you know that the string of needles needs to be at least 1.5 meters long before it will start to flower? That's very interesting, isn't it? I should measure this to see how long it is at the moment. It's very rainy outside and I'm sitting on my nice and comfy pillow and I was thinking it would be the perfect day to do some propagation jobs. And I know it's the end of the season, but my plants are still growing and I was thinking today is the day. There are so many ways to propagate your houseplants. You can take cuttings and put them into water. Some houseplants you can put straight into soil. You can use perlite or sphagnum moss. You can do air layering. You can divide plants. There are even some houseplants that you can grow from seed. Today I'm going to use water, I'm going to use soil, and I'm going to divide two of my plants. And for those last two, I'm a tiny little bit nervous. I will tell you why in a bit. But first, I would like to start with the easy jobs. So I really hope you will join me. I hope you will like this video. If you did, after watching this, please subscribe to my channel and click on the like button and send me a nice message to get to know each other a little bit better. And let's go into this video. So I have this little corner in my living room and all the way up there in the back, I have a quite big Scindapsus pictus growing. Let me give you a little bit of a close up. Now, one of the vines was very long and I decided to drape it over this painting over here. It was growing down and it was going disappearing all the way behind my little chair that I have over here. And then I have a few little vines on that side that look very pretty. And then we have this one. And this is the one I want to propagate. Now, if you go over here on this little shelf, I also have a little Scindapsus cutting that I took a while ago, and I was thinking it would be very nice to turn this into a very nice full plant. I made this little shelf with a piece of very old wood that I found outside on the streets, and I used the ends of this wood to make the little brackets. I think you call this brackets. But when you cut wood that looks very old on the outside, when you cut it, the ends look very fresh and new, and I always think that's very ugly. So a little trick for you, what I always do in cases like this is that I just take a little bit of potting soil, I make it a little bit wet, and then I rub it into the grain of the wood, and this gives it a very natural old look. Basically you just make it very dirty. But I love this shelf. I think it is very rustic and very pretty, and I'm very happy with it. Now we are at this little shelf anyway. Let me show you my string of needles because it is growing so long all the way down and it is almost reaching the floor. Did you know that the string of needles needs to be at least 1.5 meters long before it will start to flower? That's very interesting, isn't it? I should measure this to see how long it is at the moment. So let me climb up my little chair to show you where I'm going to cut this. Now, most people would cut this somewhere in the middle, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to cut it right below this leaf over here, because I do want to have quite a long stem, and I'm going to tell you why in a minute. So I'm going to put my Scindapsus cuttings in this lovely glass bottle. And I actually like collecting bottles like this. I often go to secondhand stores and I pick them up for, I don't know, 25 cents, 50 cents. And I think they are very lovely. They are all different. And I really like that. To have a little collection of these on my kitchen shelf always makes me very happy. Also jars like this. I think they are very lovely. This big one I'm going to use for a different cutting I'm going to take today, a very big cutting. And this one was something I actually found in the trash. So this one was for free. So I think I'm going to make 4 cuttings out of this. I could make more, but for what I want to do, 4 cuttings is enough. I am going to leave the stems that I'm going to put in the water as long as possible. The reason for this is that with my last Skindepsis cutting, it started to rot, not only one time, but 2 times. And in the end, I decided to put a little tiny drop of bleach into the water, and then it really perked up and it did fine. And maybe you are thinking, bleach in the water that you give to your plants, you are going to kill them. But I'm not. Adding a little bit of bleach is really not going to hurt your plants at all. It is just going to prevent bacteria from growing in there. You can also use it for cut flowers. If you have cut flowers, you can add a little bit of sugar and a tiny little bit of bleach, and they will stay pretty for quite a while. Let's see where I want to cut this. About here. So I am going to remove the bottom leaf because I want to have a node. And just in case that it is going to rot, I have plenty of space to remove parts of the stem if necessary. It's always such a nice feeling to have cuttings growing. I always keep them on my kitchen shelf, very close to my sink, so I do not forget to refresh the water. It is a good idea to do that at least once a week. It's not a big problem if you forget, but it is better for the cuttings to keep it very nice and fresh. These little Skindepsis cuttings can go over here next to my string of needle propagation. It's very hard to see because they are so very tiny. I actually hurt my thumb when I was laying a brick pathway in the garden, and I was thinking maybe I should buy some green nail polish to amp up my green little thumb. What do you think? Underneath this little shelf I have a Philodendron silver sort. It is quite a big plant. It's very beautiful. It has a few vines growing in this pot, and one of them is growing a very long side shoot, and I actually want to remove this because I want this plant to grow up and not outwards. And I did a lot of thinking about this because I do really like it and I do not want it to look awkward, but we will see. We will see how it's going to look. I'm a little bit nervous for this one. I did take Philodendron cuttings before. I also have a Philodendron emerald, red emerald, and that did very, very well. So I do think this cutting is going to be okay, but I'm a little bit nervous about how my plant is going to look. yeah, let's just take this cutting and hope for the best. I did tie this in to the other one, so I need to remove this little piece of rope. The sap that comes out of this plant is actually very sticky. It's almost like a little bit like glue, and the whole plant is sticky. It's very funny. I have to take a good look to see where I am going to cut this. I think I can cut it here. Here we go. Woo! I still have a little bit left. And this, of course, will start to grow again. So I'm going to try to move it to the middle a little bit to see if I can let it grow up. But I think I have to remove more rope to do this. So I'm going to leave it for now and just focus on this cutting, putting this into water, my sticky, sticky cutting. I actually think it looks fine like this. I'm very happy. I was worried it would be a little bit out of balance because I got used to the whole branch going that way. And I think maybe if I turn it a little bit more this way, it will look even better. I'm so pleased. It is getting darker by the minute. I'm worried that in about a half an hour I'm going to be filming in complete darkness. Let me try to show you a close-up of this cutting. I don't know if you can see it, but there are a lot of points over here and also over here where roots will start to grow. So this is a very, very good cutting. I am going to remove this bottom leaf and then I'm just going to put it in some water. So there it went. What I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this for about an hour, maybe 2 hours, just to let this little point where I cut the leaf dry out a little bit, because otherwise I am afraid that it's going to rot. So let's put this away for a minute for about an hour or two, and then I will come back to it and put it into some water. I have this very beautiful bottle over here, but I actually do not think that it's going to fit. So I think I need to find something else. So it's getting darker and darker outside. I decided to turn on the light, so I really hope the lighting is okay. I think it's okay. The next little propagation job I want to do is I want to put this very big cactus cutting into soil. And this came from my Optunia cactus that is humongous. It's very, very big. And during the summer it was outside on my balcony and it was very happy and it did grow a lot, but it was growing in all of these awkward directions and I kept bumping into it. So in the end I decided to remove this, and this morning I went to the secondhand store just to look for some terracotta pots, because I'm short of terracotta at the moment. I did not find anything, but what I did find was this very cute little tin container, and it is actually for biscuits. It's saying Betty Butter Biscuits since 1890. Of course this is not that old, but it is quite cute and it's green, and also this cutting fits very well into this container. Sometimes it's very hard to put this in a normal pot because it's so wide. And of course for the first weeks it doesn't have a root system, so it's very unstable, and the deeper you can put it into the pot the more stable it gets, and this is perfect for it. So I think it will work out very well. I did decide to drill some holes in it, of course, because the holes are quite big. I have some terracotta pieces. This was from a pot that was broken already, and I'm going to put it into the bottom to prevent the soil from coming out underneath. One thing you do have to keep in mind is when you put plants in tins like this, because I really like to do that sometimes, if you put this straight onto a shelf, if it's for example a wooden shelf or something that's painted, it is going to leave rust stains. So it is a very good idea to put something underneath it, because this is very hard to remove. You would actually have to repaint your shelf. So this is another little tip. Do not put this straight on any surface. So let me show you two more plants that I have growing in tin containers. I usually put cacti and succulents in them because they are perfect for little containers like this. This is actually from the Free University of Amsterdam. And on the back it is saying, this is a replica of the VU University Amsterdam collection box. So they had a collection box to collect money and it looked like this. Of course, probably it was a lot bigger. As a private university, VU University Amsterdam was dependent on donations and gifts. By this means, the supporters of the VU University Amsterdam were able to maintain their university for many years. So I think it's very nice that this is actually something that is from Amsterdam, because that's where I live. And then I have another, this is just a little tea container, and it also has a little succulent in it. I think it is very, very cute. I just used a normal cacti soil in this container because it has very big drainage holes and also some terracotta in the bottom. I did not add any perlite. Also, I do not have any perlite at the moment, so this is just something that I had lying around. And I am going to give it a little bit of water because when you take cuttings like this, you do have to let them dry. Or you have to put them into very, very, very dry soil. And I left this drying for, I think, more than 2 months. I actually forgot about it for a little bit. It is actually even a little bit soft. Cuttings like this, especially a very big one, they can do without water for such a long time. Now I'm looking at this and I'm noticing that I put it in the wrong way. The side of the cutting is on the front of the container. So let's turn it around very quickly because aesthetics is important too. You know, I was not paying a lot of attention. So I think that looks a lot better. Let's put this on the kitchen shelf. I was planning to do all of these projects in one video, but it is getting very late and I think this video is going to be very long. So in the end, I decided to make it into a two-part series. The second part I'm going to upload tomorrow. So I really hope to see you tomorrow again. And for now, I just want to thank you for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you in the next one. I will see you tomorrow. Bye!